Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to make the second part of assembly of a steam engine, and today we will complete this engine. See, it is rotating in perfect way. Steam engine, see, the steam will enter from this nozzle or from inlet, and it will rotate the piston. Once piston rotate, this beam will rotate, and this beam rotates this big pulley or centrifugal pulley, and this pulley drives this centrifugal pump. So this is the simple concept of a steam engine. A steam engine with horizontal beam and centrifugal pump. So let's complete this assembly, and animation we will do in next tutorial. We will make the separate simple tutorial for animation. So let's see how to make this one in SolidWorks. Now here let's start to make the second part of assembly, and we will complete this project today. So let's start. Now here we will add some more components. So choose here insert component, browse, and first we will add piston support rod. Go to desktop and steam engine assembly, and find out here piston support rod. Open, choose mat, select this hole and this rod, and make relation concentric. Okay, take it down. Just check in the depth. Select the corner edge. Actually we need to select the edge, actually not, that's it, this edge we selected, and select this face. Now you can see the preview how it's going to fixed here. Select OK. Now it's time to fix here one dome nut. So how we will make the fix any kind of dome nut here? So just go to design library, select toolbox, DIN standard, and go to nuts, and here you will find hexagon nut, and this is the hexagon cap nut, and this is dome cap nut. So just take it out and bring near to this. Now let me choose the diameter M4, schematic, no cut, select OK. Now cancel. Now just drag in upward direction. Choose mat, select the rod and the circular face, and make relation concentric, this face and nut face coincident. Okay, the nut is fixed here. Let's move for the further parts. Insert component, browse. Now the next component is crankshaft rocker. Valve linkage rocker, not crankshaft, valve linkage rocker. Open, let me rotate this component. Okay, now choose here mat, select this base hole and this hole, and make concentric relation. Select this wall face and this face. Now see coincident relation, that's it. Now let me add some more component. Come at the bottom, and we made one rod. See, rod D6 L46. Open, choose here mat, select this rod and this circular face and make relation concentric. Okay, now take it out. Select this face and this face, coincident relation. Okay, now here we want to fix one socket, so just go to design library, bolt and screw, select set screw socket, double click, and here choose socket set screw flat point DIN913, drag it, just cancel it, and again drag it because it's hidden somewhere, it should be visible. Okay, now the size we will keep M3 by 5 millimeter. Schematic. Okay, cancel it. Now this is going to fixed here, so select this hole mat and select any circular face for this. Now let's see where exactly. Okay, it comes here. Okay, now select this outer face at the outer face of rocker and make relation tangent. Okay, now this is going to fixed here. Now make one parallel relation, this one and this one, keep parallel but cancel this. Actually we want to, let's make parallel relation, parallel relation. Okay, but don't keep this relation, just go to mats, go bottom, see here parallel relation, select suppress. We want to just keep to fix with this. Now let's create a important relation, mat, choose lock, select this and this part, select here lock. Okay, okay, now let me rotate. See, the rod is rotating with rocker. Okay, let's browse the next part. Now here we will make the next part, valve linkage. Choose mat, select these two holes, concentric relation, concentric relation, select this face and this rocker face, coincident relation. Okay, insert, and here we will make one stud. We made one small stud, valve linkage stud. Open mat, select this hole and this stud, make it reverse. Okay, this face and head face. Now you can see the preview. Okay, concentric relation, now it is fixed. Cancel. Take in upward direction. Now let's add one more thing here, insert, browse, and here we will add valve. Open, rotate component, choose OK, select mat, Select this circular face and this hole. Make relation concentric. Okay. Just find out where exactly the rod gone. Just click hide. Okay, rod inside. So take it up. Okay, now let's show cylinder, show mat. Select this valve and this and make relation parallel. See here, parallel relation. Okay, this circular hole and this hole, make relation concentric. Okay, that's fine. Now here we'll fix one bolt. We created one bolt, actually a bigger bolt. Come down and here we make bolt M4 L20.7. now here we will fix this washer. See, this is the lock washer we created. So just press control key and copy. Escape. Choose your mat. Select this circular face and this circular face. Make relation concentric and this face and back side of. Now you can see the preview how it's going to fixed here. Okay. Okay. Let's rotate this bolt. Okay. Choose your mat. Select the rod and select this concentric relation. Okay. Take it out. I'll choose this spring, retaining spring, and this wall coincident relation. See, now it is fixed here. Okay, see, it's now. Let's some more component. We will now choose dual rocker, dual linkage rocker. Now just drag up to near. Now what we will do, we will fix this hole with this bore. So hide this one. Now choose mat. Select this hole and this hole. Make relation concentric. Okay. Now let me show the component rod. Click show. Now see. Choose mat. Now select this side rocker wall and base wall. A block wall coincident relation. Okay, that's look fine. Now do one thing, press control key and copy this one. Choose mat, clear, select this hole and select a circular face. Now let's see where exactly concentric relation. Select this valve and this face, tangent relation. Now it is fixed here. Now cancel it and press Ctrl key and copy this. Valve linkage. Now it's time to fix this one. Insert component, browse, and here we will fix some more components. Eccentric strap head and valve linkage bolt. Press Ctrl, open. Choose mat. Select this hole and this hole. Make relation concentric. OK. Drag out this valve, this face. Both the face we selected, and here create relation coincident. Okay, now select the hole and this bolt, concentric relation. I'll choose this face, coincident relation. Now, let me choose this face, make relation concentric. Okay. Now select this valve and this side valve, coincident relation. And here also we need to create a relation. Select this hole and this hole. See, it makes concentric relation. Okay. Now here we will fix again the same washer. So just press Ctrl key and copy this washer. Mat. This circular face and this circular face. Okay. Just undo the process because it is not visible where exactly gone this one. Drag. Now choose concentric relation, this face and this face, coincident relation. Okay, press Ctrl key and copy this bolt. Rotate. Mat. Select this hole and bolt. Undo. Drag it here. Now choose hole and bolt. Make relation concentric. Just drag it. The face of strainer ring. Coincident. Now this one is created. Okay. Now that much, save it. Save all. Rebuild and save. Now here we will fix one stud. So let me choose insert component, browse, and we created a small stud, valve linkage stud. Open, choose mat, select the hole of dual rocker and stud. See, the head goes inside, so select here flip mat alignment. Now see, it comes out. Okay, both the faces, dual rocker arm and head. Okay, now the stud also fixed. Now it's time to add some let's add some split pin here. So how we will define, just go to toolbox, DIN standard, go to pins, and here you will find parallel. In parallel you will find a split pin DIN 94. Where it goes, well, it is not visible. Actually 2 millimeter our pin, and the length keep 10 millimeter. Okay, and conical end is okay. Even you can choose flat end also. Okay, now it is asking you need one more, so I'll choose no. Now this is your small pin, take it out. Now first place in correct position. Choose mat. Now select the pin and hole. Make relation concentric. Just drag. That's it. Now let's choose fixed lock. Select this bolt and the pin, and we will make lock. This is the lock position. Select OK. Now it will not move in any place. So it is locks with bolt. Now it's time to add one more component, and this time we will add eccentric strap rod. Eccentric strap rod, open, just click this. This is the part, eccentric strap. We created one relation, we want to delete this. See, we created, okay, this coincident relation with let's hide this body. Now see, the coincident relation we created with this eccentric hub, and so delete this one, or not delete, select suppress. Now it is going to move. See, rotate and create an important relation. Choose here mat, select this circular face and select this inside hole. Concentric relation, okay. Now select the inside face of eccentric strap and this face, and make relation tangent. Just check the position. See, it's going to create. Okay, now tangent relation is created. This is very important relation. You can just drag inside. Now it's time to make the relation. Select the inside edge. see, I'll choose the inside edge and select this face, and here we will create the relation coincident. Okay, now again select and choose this concentric relation. Okay, now let's check. See, it is moving. That's it. It is moving perfectly. Now this problem also solved. Now this area is finished. Let's wrap all the things and save. Save all. Okay, our important part, bearing support show. Actually, perspective view looks better and okay. We will save this face. Rebuild and save. Now let's add some other pulley and pump. Now it's time to add centrifugal pump. So first we will bring here housing. Insert component, browse, and choose here housing and centrifugal bearing also. Press control key, housing and centrifugal bearing. The bearing and housing. Now rotate the housing. Okay. Mat. Select this base and the base of housing, base face, coincident relation. Okay. Now here choose parallel. Select this valve and this. Make relation parallel. This is important relation. Okay. Now drag it here. Select this face and make the gap 32 millimeter. Okay. Now let's add bearing. Select this hole and this face. Concentric relation. Select this face and this face. C is going to fixed here. Okay. This is a very important relation. Let's browse our next component. Turbine pulley. Rotate this portion, keep here because it will go inside. Okay, choose mat, select this face and this face, make concentric relation. Select the bearing one side face. And this face, coincident relation. Okay. Insert component. Now here let's make another part. Browse shaft, centrifugal pump shaft. rotate this side. This slotted pin keep another side bearing. Okay, select this and bearing and make relation concentric. Take select this pulley, this face, and shaft face. Make relation here coincident. Now see pulley and shaft, shaft and turbine pulley. Okay, now it is meshed with this. Okay, now let me add some other component. Browse and bring here now impeller. Just rotate the impeller. Okay. Choose mat. Select the shaft and hole. Make relation concentric. That's it. And choose bearing face. Drag it out, cancel it, just right click and fixed. Now it will be easy for us. Okay, mat, outer face of and this bearing face coincident relation. Now that's it. Okay, now impeller also fixed here. Insert component, browse, and this time choose centrifugal pump cover. Okay, I'll keep this face out. Okay, choose mat, this and this circular hole. Select both the holes, concentric relation. Select this hole and this hole. Hole and shaft concentric. Even this one no need, but it's fine. Select the housing face and this face. Now see, okay, now the cover is fixed. Now it's time to add some bolt here. So which kind of bolt do you like to add? So just go to design library, toolbox, DIN standard bolts and screw, and here we will find hexagon socket head screw, and here you will find hexagon socket head DIN 92. Drag it, cancel any relation. Where exactly the bolt? Okay, make M6, length 10 mm, threaded portion okay 10, and make cosmetic. Okay, cancel. Now drag it here. Mat. Concentric relation. Take it out. Select the cover and head back and coincident relation. Okay. Now we will use some other command and copy paste this bolt here. So how we will do this one? Just go to insert, drop down the menu of insert component, copy with mat. Select the component. Here select next. Here it will ask you mat, so choose hole. I'll choose this hole. And it is asking you face, so I'll select this face. See, choose OK. Again the same thing we have to repeat for all the holes, inside hole and face. Okay. I'll again select the cover hole and cover face. Okay. Hole, cover face. Okay. Okay, the last one, hole. This face. Okay. Cancel. Now we fixed all the bolts. Just press Control key and copy. Escape. Here also we need to fix, so better to copy with mat. Bolt, next, select this hole, select this face. Now see, okay, this is very important command while you are going to import any kind of hardware. It is very useful. Again I'll choose this hole and coincident relation this surface. See, it's come here. Okay. Cancel. Now we fix the bolt and everything. Now it's time to add now select this, right click on the body, we actually fix or select float. Now it is floating. See, let me insert component, browse, and let me bring belt. Okay, I'll keep belt like this. Mat. I'll select inside face, and here also I'll choose the belt side face and make relation concentric. Okay. And let me select this face and this face. Okay, clear this one. And we will try some edge. Try this edge. And I'll choose this edge also. Now let me see preview. Select OK. Now it is fixed perfectly. Now the same thing we will apply here. Select this face, inside face of belt, and this is the inside face of pulley, and here keep concentric relation. It's not going to create, so cancel it, and we will delete one relation, important relation, this housing. Go to mat, and here we created one relation, 32 millimeter distance, delete. Or even you can mat it, so also enough. Now try, select this face and this face, concentric relation, okay. Now I'll choose this corner, and here also I'll choose this corner, coincident relation, okay. Cancel it. Now let me select evaluate measurement, select this two wall, and we will find the mid gap 32 millimeter. So it's now the body is fixed, no need to define or anything. This is the oil gap. Select cover and hide. Even we can select one more relation, mat, select this face and this face parallel. Parallel, okay. Now we need to choose the pulley, cancel it, select this turbine pulley, and select front plane of turbine pulley, and select impeller. Just search where exactly the impeller, maybe you'll find at bottom, centrifugal pump impeller, front plane of pulley, drop down the menu of impeller, press control key and choose top plane. Now two planes we selected, you can see the preview, select mat. Now see, it is both in parallel, both in coincide, okay. If you rotate pulley, see, if you rotate pulley, the blade will be rotated. That's nice. Now it's time to add some relation. Here you will find one relation, belt and chain. Now select this face and this face. See, both the faces we selected. Now this is the diameter of selected pulley, 30 millimeter, and everything rest keep as it is. Choose OK. Now let me drive. See, if you will rotate, you will feel here. Just drive, see, the big pulley rotate the small pulley, and if pulley rotate, the shaft will rotate, and this belt just hide come down. Hide. See? So this is the our engine assembly. It is completed. Now let me just show the last centrifugal. Show component. If I will hide, click this one and just select transparent view. Now rotate. See how engine is going to rotate. So this is your simple steam engine with horizontal beam and centrifugal pump. This beam, click open. Make little more dark. It seems light. That's fine. Okay. Cancel here. Now it is see dark. Now save this assembly. It will ask you to save this one. Save. Actually supposed to add some bearing inside, but let's that okay final. Right click and transparent changed. Now let's rotate. See, so this is the steam engine, simple steam engine. What will happen? The steam will enter from this inlet and it will move the piston, and this with the help of this piston, this big pulley pump pulley rotate, and this pump pulley rotate this centrifugal pump. So this is the simple concept of a steam engine. I hope you like it. So don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. For this animation, I'll make animation in the next episode. So don't forget to share and like our video. Thanks for watching.